Halo semuanya. I'm Alex, an international student from Indonesia. I'm studying a Bachelor of Social Work here at UniSA, meaning my main campus is McGill. But I live really close to the city, so that's why I use the City West campus more. City West is located in the city center of Adelaide on the western side of things. So I'll be showing you around campus to see what facilities they have here. Let's get started. If you're planning to study a degree in the areas of business, law, art, architecture, planning, and design, then this is the campus you will be based at. Firstly, I want to show you how convenient the public transport is. We are currently standing in the front of the campus facing North Terrace in front of us. And as you can see, there's a tram stop right across the road. It's also a 5-minute walk to the train station, which is also on North Terrace. And there are many bus stops along this road. So if your accommodation is out of the city, it's quite easy for you to get to campus if you don't have a car. As an international student, you'll be offered the same public transport discounts as a local student. The pass that you can get, which I have as well, can be used for all buses, trains, and trams around Adelaide. All right, I'll show you the facilities now. Across the road, there's a really amazing teaching and research facility called the Bradley Building. I'll show it to you. In this building, pharmacy and pharmaceutical science students learn in facilities and laboratories to explore areas like medicine development. It's also where many of our cancer researchers are located. On our ground floor is a Museum of Discovery, known as MOD. There are usually exhibitions focused on science and art, which are open to the general public. It's also the only one of its kind in South Australia. It's free, so you should check it out. I just came here with my friends a few months ago, and it's really interesting. There's so many interactive things you can do, and once again, it's free, so what's to lose? All right, time for the next space. Welcome to the home of UniSA's business programs. We're at a Yeongganju building. Just walking up the steps. Here we are at the atrium. There's a concierge here. His name is Milan. Hi, Milan.
Hello.
As you can see, there are collaborative spaces for business students to study together. In these rooms, UniSA often holds executive education workshops. So you start being around people in business from the time you start uni. You also see some live financial data feeds around this building. And we have a financial trading room just over there for students studying finance courses. As you can see, there's actually a class going on for the cool guys. We'll just walk over there. And over here, we have the Business Student Hub, and the staff can help you with your study plans, electives, or any challenges you're having, and help you organize an internship as well. On the other side, we also have the Business Careers Team. They run lots of events for business students to help meet industry contacts. They also run the Business Career Mentor Program, where students can get paired up with someone in the industry to be their mentor. We're gonna be going to the next area now. As you may or may not know, Adelaide's really accepting of all different religions and cultures. There's actually a prayer room here in UniSA. Well, I can't show it to you right now, but it's just a few buildings down from where we are. In that sense, there's also a lot of multicultural things going on in Adelaide all the time. There's actually, a party like a few days ago at UniSA. There's henna, South African music, Indian music, paella for food. Yeah, it's really cool. Like, I think it's just a way for you to connect with the community, even though you're really far away from home. It's really nice like that. Walking up the stairs, by the way. Well, I'll flip the camera now so you can see the other area we're going to. So in this building, there's a post office, which is really convenient if you want to do your mailing activities or maybe send a package to someone. In Australia or overseas. Anyways, if you're wanting to grab some food on campus, this is the place to come. You'll find lots of good options and can eat here at one of the tables or get takeaway. Once again, it's really convenient to get food on campus. There's a few restaurants around the area. I personally do like this one. get the dumplings if you guys can. Okay, so we're gonna go into the student lounge now, which is this big building inside here. The space was designed by students, for students, and it's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. As you can see, there's a lot of people inside at the moment.
Yeah, we're going to head over to the kitchen facilities, which is, they do have a microwave, they have a toaster. Well, it's actually just like a toast machine. So you can heat up a food, your food if you're, you know, bringing lunch to school. There are vending machines if you want it as well. Energy drinks, soft drinks, and all that. Oh, and one more thing is that you can recharge your devices here. So if, you know, for some reason you need recharge, I guess. And one of my other favorite things about campus is that they have lockers, so you can lock your stuff and keep it safe. All you have to do is just read the instructions and yeah, locked. Now we're gonna head over to USASA. It stands for the University of South Australia Student Association. Hi! They provide services including the student board and look after all the social clubs and societies. As you can see, it's a student space. You can take a nap, relax. There are things like on the other side, I'll show you. There's the pool table, the ping pong table. Yeah, I think it's just a really cool space for students to, you know, enjoy their time, relax a bit, maybe take breaks from their classes. And it's warm as well inside, so. If you're looking to improve your English for the university's English language entry requirements, then we have CALUSA. CALUSA is a center for English language here at UniSA. They have a lot of programs to help you develop and improve your language skills. It's located here in this building up here beside me in the student lounge. So it's really easily accessible for you guys. Well, that's a wrap for the student lounge. I'm gonna bring you to another facility. I really love this alleyway right here, you guys can see. It's a lot of fun places. Oh. Yeah, well, we're gonna be walking ahead and there's actually this coffee nook here. Well, I can't show it to you guys, like you can see it in the background later. Yeah, this is the coffee nook, really cool. I usually get lattes here. I don't do well with coffee, but oh well, it's really good. Yeah, so I'm involved in a lot of a few volunteer programs, for example, like the Uni Mentor program. Yeah, it's really cool. Like, I basically help new students to adapt to their new life here at university. You might get a mentor, and you can be a mentor as well in the future, which is really cool. Well, I'm going to flip the camera because I'm going to show you another building. This building in red here is the UniSA Legal Advice Clinic. It's where law students practice their skills and provide legal advice to clients under the supervision of a managing solicitor. There's also a dedicated space for students to practice their skills in a setting that replicates a court, which I find really interesting. I'm really intrigued of what the court looks like. So maybe I'll ask one of my law friends if I can join their class. Once again, as a UniSA student, you have access to all campuses, not just your home campus. Like I mentioned in the first part of the video, I'm actually a McGill student studying social work, but I use the City West campus because I really live like just a few minutes away. Another like really cool thing is that 20 minutes from here is the Adelaide Central Market in Chinatown. That's where I usually get my groceries. The next building I'm going to be showing you guys is probably a building you know. It's the Pridham Hall. Yeah, that's where all the graduation ceremonies happen. Really fun events, sports activities as well. I'll be showing you guys what's inside. So, let's go inside, guys. I'm gonna be entering through these doors. So this is the foyer area of Pridham Hall. It's a really huge space. It's really cool. There's a really cool lighting thing there going on. I don't know what it is, but well. Well, I'm going to be showing you one of my favorite things about Pridham Hall, which is the underground swimming pool. I'm going to go a bit in front, but like, it's 25 meters, has 5 lanes for lap swimming, and it's heated. As an international student, you can sign up for affordable swimming lessons if you don't know how to swim, which is really important when you're visiting the beaches here. All right, let's have a look at the sports court now. These courts are used for sports like basketball, netball, and badminton. You can also see in the back corner, we have a rock climbing wall. So there's a club you can even join if you're interested in learning how to rock climb. There's actually a tournament going on right now, so that's really cool. When you start uni, you'll be invited to an international welcome reception event, and it'll take place here. The room gets fully transformed and with lots of tables and activities. And down the stairs is where we have the UniSA Sport Counter, and there's a gym down there too. The gym is open to all students and the public. A bonus is that students get discounted rates, and you can even do group classes like Pilates and HIT. I'm actually going to be signing up for the swimming classes. It's around $20 for 4 sessions. I think it's really worth it. It's going to be exciting, and yeah, the wind's really strong. Well, I'll show you something which is something you should know. Behind there, that's where its security is, so it's called FM Assist. They can help you with things like if you need emergency assistance or someone to walk you to your car at night. I think it's really helpful, especially when you're studying like until like 12 a.m. And here in front of us, we have the Jeffrey Smart Building, which has 6 floors of library and study spaces. This is where we find most other students studying or working on assignments, well, like me, I guess. As much as we would like to show you around every level, we will just walk up the stairs to the second floor. We're gonna show you around. But on the ground floor is where you'll find career services. You can drop in to get career advice and support if you're wanting to get a part-time job. Also importantly, there are lifts in this building, so if you're not really keen on taking up the stairs, yeah, you can always use that. Just a few more steps. Yep. So here in level 2 is where you can get help when you need it. I'll be showing you Campus Central, which is just actually the desk behind me, but let's go with this side. So as you can see the desk there, that's when you can help from get help from Campus Central. You can get support services like counseling and disability, and also enrollment and your student ID. So this is the last space I'll be showing you guys here. It's the library. The library is spread across 5 floors with books that you can borrow, computers you can use, and lots of meeting room areas you can book to do group work with other students or if you want some alone time. Every second floor also has kitchen facilities, so you can heat up your lunch, boil water, or get a snack from a vending machine. Now, if you're trying to find something, you can search for it using a digital wayfinder screen, like the one in front of me right now. You can use it to book a meeting room or find a service. So for example, if you wanted to know where the printers are, you can click this, click on the second floor. Oh, yeah, basically that's where the printers will be. Alright everyone, that is it for the City West Campus Tour. I hope you enjoyed it. Well, see you around campus.